Hello YouTube, this is Kids from YouTube here, and I'm going to be doing a read-along of the 2014-15 Aladdin.
Is yours, but the lamb is mine. The tiger god stopped the thief. Of palace life.
Suddenly, a fool grabbed Aladdin. Razul, following Jafar's orders, hauled him away. While Jasmine mourned losing Aladdin, Abu found him chained in a dark dungeon, thinking only of her. Jafar, disguised as a prisoner, limped toward Aladdin.
I know where there is a cave, boy, with enough treasure to impress even the lovely princess. I need a young pair of legs and a strong back to go after it.
I would gladly help, Zerman. How do we get out of here?
Jafar moved a stone, and a hidden staircase was revealed. Moments later, they were racing across the desert. Jafar led them to the Cave of Wonders. This time, the tiger god allowed Aladdin to enter. Jafar called in after the boy.
Remember, first bring me the lamp. Then you may touch the treasure, but not before.
Inside, Aladdin and Abu discovered a huge cavern filled with riches.
Would you look at that? Not just a handful of the stuff would make us richer than the Sultan.
It was difficult for Abu to keep from grabbing the fortune before them. As Abu and Aladdin explored the cave, a golden tasseled carpet came to life and played peekaboo with them.
Look, Abu, how magic carpet!
The carpet floated closer.
The ruler must have called you for the lamp, too. Do you know where it is?
The carpet zipped off to reveal a huge cavern. The lamp rested at the top of a high stone staircase. While Aladdin climbed, Abu eyed a monkey idol holding a huge jewel nearby. Just as Aladdin reached the lamp, Abu grabbed the jewel. Instantly, the voice of the tiger god echoed through the chamber. Shook violently, and the piles of treasure transformed into mountains of fire. Aladdin, Abu, and the carpet scrambled to escape. At the cave entrance, Iago squawked. From above, Jafar reached down to grab Aladdin's hand.
Just give me the lamp.
Jafar clutched the lamp and quickly hid it under his robe. Then he released Aladdin and brushed Abu off his cloak, sending them hurtling back into the cave.
It's mine! It's all mine! With the power of this lamp, I will control the kingdom!
But when Jafar reached back into his robe for the lamp, it was gone. The magic carpet cut the tumbling duo as the cave entrance closed, and everything became still. Chattering excitedly, Abu happily revealed the lamp. Aladdin laughed. Aladdin rubbed some dirt off the lamp to get a better look. Colorful smoke spewed out of the spout, and it took the form of a gigantic genie.
Say, you're a lot smaller than my last master.
Aladdin was stunned.
Wait a minute. I'm your master?
Right here for your wish fulfillment. 3 wishes to be exact.
One of those things.
In a dazzling display, the genie demonstrated his magical powers. Aladdin cleverly tricked the genie into rescuing them from the cave without using up a wish. Then he smiled at his newfound friend.
Genie, if you could have a wish, what would you wish for?
To be my own master. Such a thing would be greater than all the magic and all the treasures in all the world.
I'll set you free. I'll use my 3rd wish to set you free.
The genie was delighted.
Let's make some magic.
What do you want most?
Well, could you make me a prince?
In a flash, the genie created elegant robes and servants for Aladdin and turned him into Prince Ali. Back at the palace, Jafar and Iago discussed what to do next. Iago got an idea.
Marry the princess and
official-looking scroll to far read out loud. If a princess is not chosen a husband by her next birthday, then the sultan shall choose four. And in the event a suitable prince cannot be found, the princess may wed the royal vizier. Let's be using his snake-eyed staff to hypnotize the sultan. Jafar ordered him to arrange the marriage. Dressed as Prince Ali, Aladdin rode triumphantly to the Agrabah Bazaar and
there for part one.